resistors in series. So why we have to connect the resistors in series? What is the purpose? In some cases, in some electronic circuits or in some electrical circuits, we need to have more resistance value. In that case, we should not modify the dimension of the conductor. So we cannot modify the length, we cannot modify the area of cross section. That will become a difficult task. Nowadays, technology has been improved a lot. So nowadays we are having carbon resistors. I will tell you about the carbon resistors later. The carbon resistor is the cheap and best resistor. We need not connect the wires. We need not, because every conductor will offer you resistance. So we need not connect wires in electronic circuits, in electrical circuits. We just fix some carbon resistor, because every carbon resistor is having some definite value. So if you want to connect some resistors in series, so what will be the result that we will check here? So depends on the result, we will proceed further. I initially take three resistors. They are having different values. I don't take wires. I am taking only carbon resistors. They are having discrete values. I take three resistors, namely R1 and R2 and R3. We have three resistors, right? And they are connected in series. How to connect in series? This end should be connected to this end. The last end should be connected to the first end, right? That is, the output is given to the input. And this output is given to input for this. So this connection is called a series connection. Okay. So when this end is connected to the positive terminal of the battery, okay, and this end to negative terminal of the battery, what will happen? This circuit is called a closed circuit. So what will happen? Current is? Yeah, it starts flowing from positive to negative. You tell me, same amount of current will flow through all the resistors, or different current will flow through all the resistors? Resistor values are different. This is R1, this is R2, this is R3. You tell me, same current will flow or different current will flow? Different current will flow. But we have only one route. Same current only should flow. You see, there is a river. There may be some pits everywhere, but the flow of water is same or not? In the river, the flow of water will be same or not? Same water, same flow only will be there everywhere. So that is called a series connection. There may be some ups and downs in the river, but the water flow will be the same. In a similar manner, you can compare that with the series connection. Same current only will flow through all the resistors, even though they have different resistance values. Same amount of current will flow all, will flow through all the resistors. You understand this? You understand this? But there will be some voltage drop. Potential difference will be different. See, there is one famous law, I will tell you. So we have, what is voltage, what is resistance, what is current? The famous man, George Simon Ohm, he did one experiment. What he did? He took one wire. That wire is connected to battery. That has resistance R. He increased voltage. He increased voltage. First he used 2 volt and he determines the current. That current will flow through R. Then he increased the volt, 4 volt. Then he determines the value of current. Then he increased 6 volt. In steps of 2 volt, he is increasing the voltage. And for every current, for every voltage, the corresponding current has been measured. and he finds the table, and that shows the value of voltage is proportional to the current. Whenever the voltage value increases, the current flow through the conductor also increases. That has been found by, so volt is directly proportional to current. So according to him, the Ohm's law, the statement is nothing but at constant temperature, the temperature should be constant. Because I will tell you why the temperature should be constant. Because when temperature changes, the resistance also changes. Right? Resistance is the temperature dependent quantity. I will tell you and explain later. So at constant temperature, when a steady current, the current also should not change. When steady current flows through the conductor, potential difference is directly proportional to the current. Potential difference is the voltage value given to the conductor. So volt is directly proportional to I. Then, okay, V is equal to some constant we have to put. Here the constant is, what is that? R. What is that? R. So here R is constant of proportionality, which we call it as resistance. So from this we can calculate the resistance by R equal to V by R. If you divide the voltage by current, you can get the resistance. Here which is constant here? Here I is constant. So here R proportional to V. So here the resistance value differs. So definitely the voltage drop across the resistor will also differ. Here the potential difference across this one is V1, and potential difference across this one is V2, and potential difference across this one is V3, right? But the total supplied voltage is V. The total voltage given by the battery is split up into 3, that's it. Suppose if you supply 10 voltage, if you are having 10 volt battery, that 10 volt is split up into 3. Here may be 5 volt, here may be 3 volt, here may be 2 volt. You can check it with instrument. If you connect a voltmeter across each resistor, you can measure the values, and if you sum it up, that will give you the 10 volt. So mathematically I can write it as V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Is that right? But according to Ohm's law, you can say that V is equal to I into R. The total supplied voltage is total current into total resistance of the system, the network. All the resistors will give you the effective resistance, that is called RS. S stands for series. So series resistance. Okay. And this one, how will you write V1? How will you write V1? Very simple. The product of current and resistance is nothing but voltage. How will you do this? I into
R1.
That's it. I into R1. How will you write V2?
I into R2.
Yes, I into R2. How will you write V3?
I into R3.
That's it. I into R3. So you can take I common, R1 plus R2 plus R3, and that should be equal to I into RS. So you can cancel I. So you will get RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, right? We have connected R1, R2, R3 in series in the circuit. But what is the result we have? R1 plus R2 plus R3. Say for example, if you connect 1 ohm here, 2 ohm here, 3 ohm here, what is the total resistance? 1 plus 2 plus 3, you can have 6 ohm here. So if you want to, what is the value of 6? That 6 is greater than the greater value we have connected. So we are connecting 3 resistors. Which one is the greatest value? 3. But the result is greater than the greater value. What? Not twice, not like that. Greater than the greater value. What is the value is greater here? 3. But our result will be more than this. More than the large value which we use in the circuit. Suppose if you use 10 ohm is the maximum resistance in the circuit, but your result will be more than that. Right? That is the result of the series connection.